Om Shuklam Baradharam Vishnum Shashivarnam Chaturbhujam Prasannavadanam Dhyayet Sarva Vigno Pashantaye Ramaya Ramabhadraya Ramachandraya Vedhase Raghunathaya Nathaya Sitaya Pataye Namaha Om. Dear friends, welcome to Valmiki Ramayana. We are seeing the interesting episode where Ravana is trying to seduce Sita. That is, we are seeing Sarga number 55, Sarga number 55 of Aranyakanda, where Ravana, he has now taken Sita, he has abducted Sita, kept her in his palace in Lanka, and forcibly he showed the entire palace. You see all the wealth here, and all the wealth of the whole world is here. So that is what he was demonstrating. And he says, you be the queen of all the wives, you be the chief queen. And not only that, all your past sin has come to an end. We believe that there is some karma. Karma is the human being. If I am born today, according to our system, I had so many previous janmas. And in those so many previous janmas, it may be a human janma or it may be some animal janma. I do not know whether I was a human being earlier. I do not know whether I was a lion or a dog, whatever it was. And in those other lives, there is no question of papa or punya. That is only bhoga bhumi. If somebody is born as a dog or somebody is born as a pig, there is no karma there. But in the human life only that karma is there. So, and as many lives as we have, there is so much of karma also. In every life, we do some good karma, some bad karma. Some good karma gives some punyam, bad karma gives some papam. So, and the result of all these punyam or papam will not be enjoyed or will not be experienced in one life. And you will have to take life again and again and again. So, that is our karma doctrine. So, here, what Ravana is saying is that what all past papam, whatever sins you have committed earlier, all those things, they are all exhausted because you stayed in that vanavasa, you stayed in that forest. You lived with that poor man, and you had a very, very tough time in that forest. So all your past karma is gone. Now your punya karma has now begun. It has now begun to give fruit. Now that you are here, all your punya karma is now giving fruit. Yachate sukruto dharma. Your punyam is now fructified. It's now giving fruit. Tasyeha phalam apnuhi. And iha malyani sarvani, all types of pleasure, all types of pleasurable things, they are all here. And now, above all, we have got a pushpaka vimana. Pushpakam nama shishroni bhratru vaishravanasyame. And Vaishravana is Kubera. Kubera is the lord of all wealth of the entire universe. Imagine somebody who is the lord of the entire wealth of the universe. He is Lord Kubera. And he is the one who gives the wealth. So he had that Pushpaka Vimanam, and that Pushpaka Vimanam, that famous Vimana or plane, that flying machine, it is now with me. Let us move, let us go places in that. He says, Pushpakam nama shishroni, bhratru vaishravanasyacha, and then Vimanam Surya Sankasham, we will go places sitting in that. Then when he was saying all this, Sita, she was covering her face. Pidhaya indunibham Sita mukham ashrunya vartayat. Sita was covering her face with her sari, and she was shedding tears. And Ravana thinks that she is shy, because when women are shy, they cover their faces. Sita is covering her face and crying and shedding tears. And now Ravana says, alam vridena vaidehi. Vrida means lajja. Lajja is being shy. Don't be shy and don't think that you are violating some dharma. Dharma lopa krutena cha. Dharma lopa. Dharma lopa means violation of dharma. And he says, okay, you may be thinking that you are violating dharma. You are not violating dharma. This sort of sambandha, this sort of union is something which is also approved by our sages, he says. Because it is like devil quoting the Bible. In English there is a saying, like the devil quoting the Bible. So he is saying, this is arshoyam daivanishyandaha. Arshaha means something which is approved by the Rishi. Something which is approved by the Rishi is arsham. Rishi, and from that word Rishi, the word derivation is arsham. Arsham means something which is belonging to a Rishi or which is approved by the Rishi. Aryoyam daivanishyandaha. Our nishyanda. Nishyanda means our union. is something which is approved by the gods, approved by the rishis. Daiva nishyandaha. Daiva. Daiva means destiny. Daiva does not mean gods, because all the gods are again his, under his command. Daiva means destiny. This is destiny. This is something which is brought about by destiny. And this is something which is arsham, something which is also approved by the sages. And yasvam abhigamishyati. And now he touches the feet. Not only touches, he keeps the 10 heads on the feet of Sita. Yetau padau maya srigdhau shirobhih paripiditau. Touching, I am touching your feet with all my 10 heads. And prasadam kurumet shipram. You be kind to me. You do favor to me quickly. Shipram. Shipram means quickly, quickly do favor to me. Vashyo dasoham asmite. I am your vashyaha. Vashyaha means I am your servant. I am under your control. Dasoham asmi. I am your dasa. And ima shunya maya vacha shushyamanena bhashitaha. Nacha api ravana kanchit murdhanam srim pranameta. And I am somebody, shushyamanena, somebody who is a tormented. I am being heated up. Shoshanam. Shoshanam is being dried up or heated up. By what? By Manmatha. Because this Manmatha, this god of love, or what we call Manaha Mathanati, he churns the mind so much of heat is generated in the body. And my body is now having all that heat. Shushyamanena, I am being dried up by that heat. And Ravana has never bowed his head before any woman. Nachapi Ravana kanchit murdhanam stri pranamedaha. Now Ravana never bowed in front of any woman. I am now keeping all my 10 heads on your feet. Eva muktva dashagrivo maithilim janakatmajam. He used all the tricks. So initially he frightened her, he threatened her, he showed his wealth, and then all the glitter and gold and glamour of gold and all this wealth he showed. And now, and also said Rama cannot come here. So if you just see what all techniques he uses, he has like an advocate noting down various points. He has told all those things in a very, very serial manner. So first of all, he said, you be the Lord. If you just see what all he said, you be the Lord of all this empire and all this wealth. And he said, all the gods will be at your command. And he said, youth is impermanent. That is again another very tempting thing. You are now in your prime of youth. And you are going to be old after some time. And your time is fleeting underneath the feet. And youth is very, very impermanent. And your punya karma has now come to fructification. All your past sins are gone. And you are enjoying the fruit of your punya karma. And Lanka is so invincible. It is so hundreds and hundreds of miles deep into the sea. And it is so invincible and inapproachable. And Rama is too weak. Rama has, he can only dream of coming here. And you never have any dream of seeing Rama again. So he throws, and also he touches the feet of Sita. So he has used all his techniques. Sama, Dana, Bheda, etc. All those techniques he has used. And this is the behavior of somebody who is smitten by Manmatha. Kamartha, as we say. Kamartha means somebody who is smitten by Manmatha. And a very, very crafty seducer. That is also, we can give full marks to Ravana as a very, very competent, crafty seducer. Of course, we may get a doubt. Why is Ravana not using force on Sita? Why can't he forcibly have her? For that, there is a reason. We may think that Ravana, after all, he is a great lover. Like all our intellectuals think. Okay, recently there was a debate in Indian media that, oh, Sita could have been happy with Ravana. Why Ravana was such a great lover? So that is, this sort of ideas will come, not to ordinary people, these ideas will come to intellectuals. All our intellectuals, they are so swollen, with their heads are so swollen, that they get all such ideas. So they say, oh, Ravana, Sita could have been happy with Ravana. Why is Ravana so entreating? Why is Ravana so soft? Because there is already a curse on him. There is a curse on him which we are going to see later in Yuddhakanda. There is a curse from Brahma, that if he violates any woman without her will, if he violates any woman, his head is going to blast off. His head will turn into pieces. So that sort of curse is there by Brahma. So Ravana cannot use any force. Ravana is behaving like a great lover and whatnot, not because of his goodwill or anything. Ravana has no other option. Ravana can forcibly take her to some place, but he cannot forcibly have her. Because of that curse. So we should not be guided by the intellectual talk, because recently also there was a debate even on the Telugu media, Telugu screen, Telugu Telugu TV, also there was a debate that okay, well, Ravana could have been a great lover. It is something which is totally perverted way of thinking. So we now come to the 56th sarga. After all these entreaties by Ravana, the way Sita replies, Sita's conduct, you see, that is the conduct of a very, very ideal wife. And this is how the Indian society survived for thousands and thousands of years. Indian society survived with some value system. And that value system, unfortunately, is now being broken even by the courts. Even the courts are now saying, okay, a man can live with any woman. If the woman is willing, he can live with any man. She can live with any man. Even our Indian courts, with all our books like Ramayana and Mahabharata, with all the value system which was fostered and which was strengthened over thousands of years. So all that thing, our judges also have become so intelligent now. What to do? Anyway, in this 56th sarga, we now see, sa tathokta tu vaidehi, trunamantaratah kurtva ravanam pratyabhashata. She kept a trunam. Trunam means she kept a blade of grass in between. She did not look at Ravana. After all this, she did not look at Ravana. She kept a blade of grass in between, and she said, and she addressed that blade of grass. That means treating him as a blade of grass. You are like a blade of grass. I don't care for you. Raja Dasharatho nama dharma setu rivachalaha. Then she is also saying about her statement. I am the daughter-in-law of that Dasharatha, the great king. Dharma setu riva achalaha. Dharma setu. He was the person who established dharma. Dharma setu means dharma sthapakaha. Commentators write dharma sthapakaha, vyavasthapakaha. That is somebody who was like a benchmark for dharma. Somebody who was an establishing, a person who established dharma. And his son is Rama. Ramonama dharmatma satya sandhaha. Somebody who is bound by satya. Dharmatma trishu lokeshu vishrutaha. Is known in all the three worlds. And Dirghabahur Vishalashu, she is now describing Rama. And he will surely come. And yes, they pranan harishyati. Rama will surely come and will take away your life. And like he killed all those Rakshasas in Janasthana, he is surely going to kill you. Sankhye Janasthane yatha karaha. You will also die like that Kara died in that Janasthana. Asurairva surairva tam yad yavadhyosi Ravana. You may be thinking that you are invincible for all the gods and yakshas, gandharvas, etc., etc. You have got the boon from Indra. Of course, she doesn't know, or maybe he himself has told, I don't have any threat from any of these people, asura, sura, gandharva. He himself has told, so she knows it. You may be feeling that you are invincible, but Rama is surely going to kill you. Sate jivitaseshasya raghavo antakaro bali, but not for Rama. You are not invincible for Rama. You will surely be killed. And Gatayustvam Gatashrikaha. Your life has come to an end. Gatayuhu Gatashrikaha. Now we see that Ravana was trying to break her will. And Sita is so strong. She is also threatening him equally. And she is trying to break his will. Gatayustvam Gatashrikaha. Your wealth is gone. Gatashrikaha. Your wealth is gone. Gatasattvo Gatendriyaha. Lanka Vaidhavya Sanyukta Tvatkrutena. Because of your fault, Lanka is going to be widowed. The whole city of Lanka is going to be widowed. Means all the able-bodied people, all the warriors of Lanka, they are going to die. And yada vinasho bhutanam drushyate kalashoditaha. When somebody is going to die, when end has come near somebody, tada karye pramadyanti, people will do all types of sinful acts. The type of sinful act you have done, it is only because your end has come near. And now she also scolds. Similarly, I am skipping lot many shlokas. Tatha ham dharma nityasya, dharma patni pativrata. And I am dharma patni, pativrata. Pativrata means somebody who is totally dedicated to her husband. She is a pativrata. Dharma patni pativrata. Natvayas prashtum shakya rakshasadhama. You can't even touch me. You should not touch me at all. And how can a kridanti rajahamsena? I am like a rajahamsa, the royal swan. You know, in olden days, all these kings, they used to have these swans in their palaces. There are some small lakes and ponds, and they used to get some royal swans and into them. Kridanti Rajahamsena Padmashandeshu Nityada. And they used to have all these lotus ponds. And in those lotus ponds, they used to leave Rajahamsa. That is the royal swan, as we say. And how can a royal swan, the female swan, how can a royal swan go with a water crow? She compares Ravana to a water crow. Hamsisa Trunashandastham Katham Pashyeta Madgukam. Madgukam is a water crow. How can a royal swan go with a water crow? You are like a water crow. And if you may try to force this body, but certainly you are not going to have me. I am going to die. Idam shariram nissangnyam. Nissangnyam means this body is something which is totally insentient, inert, what we call jadam. Jadam. Nissangnyam is something which is jadam, which is insentient. And bandhava khadayasyava. You may try it. You may tie me somewhere. And you may eat me also. Nedam shariram rakshyam. I am not in a mood. I am not interested in saving this body. And natu sakshyam yupakrosham, and I will not deviate from dharma. Whatever you do, I am not going to deviate from dharma. And Sitaya vachanam shrutva ravam parusham romaharshanam. Sita made a very, very romaharshanam. Romaharshanam means, if you listen to that, the hair will bristle. Of course, Ravana, in the case of Ravana, his hair is bristling with anger. So hair can bristle when you are extremely happy or when you are extremely angry. So Ravana is now angry. Romaharshanam Shrutva. Ravana heard this very powerful speech. And Pratyuvacha. Then Ravana realizes that Sita is not going to yield so quickly. Then he says, Shrunu Maithili. Oh Sita, Shrunu. Shrunu means Suno. Listen. Suno. Madvakyam Masan Dvadasha Phamini. I am going to give you 12 months time. He has given some time period. So he has given long time gap. Okay, let us wait. At least in this time, maybe I may be able to bring her under my control. Masan dvadasha bhamini tatasvam pratarashartham sudashetsyanti leshasaha. Then after 12 months, if you are not going to listen to me, sudaha. Sudaha means all these cooks. They are going to cut your body into pieces. Chetsyanti, chedanam. Chedanam means cutting. Chetsyanti leshasaha. Lesha means pieces. They are going to cut you into pieces and they are going to get your body for breakfast. I am going to eat you up for my breakfast. So here also we see that Ravana is under curse, definitely under curse. Otherwise he could have forcibly had her. He could have forcibly had her. So now he is saying, I will have you as my breakfast. Pratarashartham. Pratarashaha. Prataha means morning. Ashanam. Ashanam means eating. Morning eating. What we call breakfast. Pratarashaha. Pratarasha is, nowadays the Sanskrit Bharati people also, they have adopted this word, Pratarasha, breakfast. So, then, Shigrameva hi Rakshasyo Vikruta Ghoradarshanaha. Then he immediately ordered, hey Rakshasyaha. Okay, he called all those again fearful, all these fierce demons. And Vikruta Ghoradarshanaha, all the cruel looking, all these fierce looking demons he called, Darpamasya Vineshyadvam. She is very proud. And you have to bring down her pride. You have to bring down her, break her will and break her pride. And they surrounded Sita, Kurta Pranjalayo. They said, oh, yes, sir. And then surrounded Maithili in Paryavarayan. They surrounded Sita. And they all, then Ravana was so angry that he was stamping his foot on the ground as though he was tearing up the ground. Prachalya charanotkarshaihi, charanotkarshaihi, charanam is foot. Charanotkarshaihi means he was just stamping the ground as though he was tearing the ground. Darayanniva medinim, daranam is tearing. Medinim darayanniva. And he says, Ashokavanika madhye maithili niyata niyatamiyam. Let you take her to that Ashokavana. Ashokavana is a sort of pleasure garden. We are going to see the description of this Ashokavana in Sundarakanda. It's a very beautiful garden. And exclusively for Ravana, and securely kept. No man can enter there. No man can enter there, only female gods. And maybe people like this, Sita, who are kept there and then who are there kept for intimidation and then for taming purposes. So, Ashokamanika madhye maithili niyatamayam tatreyam rakshyatam gudham. Let her be kept there. Gudham. Gudham is very secretly, very guarded, very secretly, in a very, very guarded manner, very cautiously you guard her, very secretly. Yushmavi parivarita, you always surround her and keep her, guard her properly. Tatrainam tarjanaihi ghoraihi punai santvaishya maitilim. You threaten her and also speak to her santvanam. Threaten her and santvanam. This is a technique which he says. Tarjanam means threatening. You know that this finger is called tarjani. In Sanskrit, we have got names for even those fingers. In English, of course, thumb is there. This is one finger, this is pointing finger. But in Sanskrit, there are five names. This is, of course, thumb. This is called angustha. This is called tarjani. Tarjani means when you are frightening someone, you use this finger. We don't use this finger for frightening. You use this finger for frightening. This is called madhyama. This is called anamika. And this is called kanishthika. Kanishthika, anamika, madhyama, tarjani, and angustha. So, tarjani. Tarjanam means threatening. So, he says, tatrainam tarjanair ghoraihi. That is, you threaten her. You frighten her, and then you have to break her will. Basically, the idea is you have to break her will. Not only that, punaha santvaischa. Santvanam is gentle talk. That is, blow hot, blow cold. Nowadays, even the armed forces, sometimes the police and the people who want to interrogate somebody, the army, suppose you catch the enemy, some enemy soldier, and that enemy soldier is under interrogation to reveal where all your forces are there, where are your weapons, where is your equipment and all that thing, what is the type of your equipment, etc., etc. And this sort of interrogation is a very, over a period of time, this interrogation techniques have grown. And this interrogation, if we see, probably these things, they were very well developed during the Second World War. There are so many books about the techniques of interrogation. If you see books like brainwashing, all these brainwashing techniques and interrogation techniques were developed by not only one army, not only Russian army or Chinese army, but US people, or even recently we hear about various types of interrogations by all types of armies. And in those interrogations, there are two persons, one team, one person, or one team comes and frightens. Then after some time, another person comes and acts in a very friendly way. No, don't use force, he tells the other man. And this person under interrogation, if he does not know that it is a technique, he realizes, he feels, oh, this man is my friend. And then gradually some sort of trust builds up. So this is called a blow hot, blow cold technique, or a good cop, bad cop. Even the police also have adopted from armed forces. So the good cop, bad cop technique, and then some sort of rapport develops. So like that, you interrogate this woman and then break her will, tame her, taming her, he says. Anayadvam vasham sarva vanyam gajavadhu miva. Gajavadhu. Gaja means an elephant, a female elephant. Gajavadhu means a female elephant. And how are elephants tamed? They dig huge pits in the forest. And on the surface, they put some sort of grass. They put some small reed type of thing, and then over that some grass. And elephant doesn't know that there is a pit. Elephant just walks into that and falls in the pit. And once it is in the pit, it cannot come up. So there it is made to starve for some time, and slowly it is brought under control, and slowly it is taken out, and it is taken out to some place. So like that, the human beings, they control all the wild animals. So like that, anayadvam vasham sarvaha, all the people, you properly interrogate this lady. Vanyam gajamadhumiva, like that female elephant, you have to tame her and bring her under control. Iti pratisamadishtha rakshasyo ravanena sataha. So Ravana gave instructions about how she has to be interrogated. We see that human nature is one the same. Now in the 20th century, we talk about good cop, bad cop technique. And Valmiki also knows it. Anyway, then he says, Ashokavanikam jagmuhu, they all took her to Ashokavanika. Satu Shoka Sarvakala Palair Vrkshaihi. And Ashokavana is a place where the trees, they give fruits in all seasons. There are different types of fruits, not that the same tree gives fruits in all seasons. There are fruits for all seasons. Sarvakala Palair Vrkshaihi. Fruits are available in all seasons. Nana Pushpa Palair Vrtam. So from this we have to infer that probably she was surviving on some fruits. Sita was surviving on some fruits. And Satu Shokaparisangi, Maithili Janakatmaja, Rakshasi Vashamapanna. So she was now under the control of all these Rakshasis. like a deer surrounded by tigresses. Vyagrinam hariniyatha. Vyagri means a female, that is a tigress. Harini. Harini means a female deer. Like a deer under the control, under the custody of tigresses. She was like that. She was so frightened. Navindate tatra dusharma maithili. Sita. She was absolutely no happiness. No sharma. Sharma means happiness. Natatra sharma maithili. And vichetana bhut bhayashoka pedita. She was so totally frightened to see all that. So, of course, some people may doubt, okay, why Sita is an incarnation of this, that, Lakshmi or whatever it is. Why can't Sita curse her? Because Valmiki portrays both Rama and Sita as human beings only. And Sita is showing the ideal behavior of a wife, even under extreme stress, even under extreme compulsion. She is showing that she is a Pativrata. And Sita is, that is the reason why Sita is the role model for thousands of years. Sita has been the role model for thousands of years for the Indian women. So that is what it has been. And Sita cannot conduct herself as the goddess or anything like that. She has to conduct herself as a human being. So that is how Valmiki also has portrayed. And now here, there is a small sarga, which is the next sarga after 56. There is a sarga which is interpolation. It is an interpolated sarga that is called Prakshipta sarga. Prakshipta sarga, that is somebody at some point of time, some centuries ago, because this sarga seems to be there in several recensions. This sarga is there in this Gorakhpur edition, this sarga is there in Eastern edition, this sarga is there in the Western edition. It is there, probably it was inserted by somebody some centuries ago, but the commentators have not commented on this, but everybody said it is a Prakshipta sarga. Prakshipta means something which has been interpolated because it is not in tune with the overall scheme of things. It is not in tune with Valmiki's way of presenting the character. So what is there in this chapter? Here in this chapter what we see is that Lord Brahma, he directs Indra, okay, now Sita is there, she is kept in that Ashokavana. She will be there in that Ashokavana. She will not be taking any food and she will starve. So now you go. You go and give her some payasam, some divine payasam. Payasam, we know. Payasam means some sweet dish made of payaha. Payaha means milk. Payaha is milk. Payas is milk. And payasam means something made of milk. That means some sort of drink. Okay, let us say. Drink means not alcoholic drink. Drink is that payasam, that sweet dish. You go and give to her so that she will not have this hunger and thirst for 1 year. She will not have hunger and thirst for 1 year and she will also be safe. She will be safely waiting for Rama. So that is what is the theme of this sarga, where Indra is directed by Brahma to go there. And Indra goes, he also takes along this Nidra Devi. Nidra Devi means the goddess of sleep. And this goddess of sleep goes and covers all these guards, female guards. And all the female guards, they fall asleep. So dead asleep. And at that time, Indra approaches Sita. Indra approaches Sita. He reveals himself. He says, yes, I am sent by Brahma. And you take this payasam so that you can survive. Then Sita immediately does not trust. How do I know that you are Indra? Then Indra reveals himself in his own form. He reveals himself and then he stands in air, not on the ground, not touching the ground. Because the devas, when the devas gods come, they stand in air only. Their feet do not touch the ground. And like that, all the signs of insignia of Indra, all those things he shows. And then Sita also accepts. Yes, okay, Sita accepts it. Okay, I will take this payasam. And she takes that payasam. And jahuk shudha, dukkha samudbhavantam, shudha. Shudha means hunger. So she doesn't have hunger after that. So she stayed there like that. This is a Prakshipta sarga, for which, as I said, there is no commentary by any writer. And in fact, so it could have been written by some devotee. It could have been written by some devotee to say that, okay, gods took care of her or something like that. And it does not enhance the character of Sita. Because if we see, it does not enhance the character of Sita. And on the other hand, it is bringing down the character of Sita. If Sita is there, very happily sitting there without any hunger or thirst, and then happily waiting to see Rama, then her character, there is no greatness in her character. So this Prakshipta Sarga is something which we need not bother about. We will go to the next Sarga tomorrow. Harihi Om Tat Sat.